In previous lessons, we've looked at the VLookup formula and we've also looked at the match formula separate, and we looked at combining match with index. But match is also a very useful tool to combine with VLookup to make your VLookup more robust and more dynamic. One of the problems that people have with VLookups and one of the errors that occurs is people come along to your table of data and they insert a row. Now, you can lock and you can protect your worksheets to stop people from doing this, but in some circumstances, this is just not an option for you. So let me show you what happens if somebody comes along and somebody inserts a column of data. So we have our VLookup formulas here from our basic VLookup tutorial. And you'll remember that we pulled in the in stock and the on order and the stock value. So let's just insert a column here. So let's just insert cells and we'll move them to the right. And you'll see when we move them to the right, our VLookup formulas changed value. In stock, it's now saying that there is zero, where we know in stock there is 18. On order, it's saying that there is 18, but we know that there is 6. And our stock value is shown as 4, whereas we know it's 72. And obviously, this will vary depending on the stock code that you actually pick. So the way around this is to combine VLookup with match. So don't forget, match will return the relative position in a list. And one of the criteria that you need for your VLookup is the row number. So you can return the row number using the match function. Let's have a look at combining VLookup and match together, and it'll be an awful lot more simple when we look at it in practice. So equals VLookup. The lookup value, so this is the value we're going to look up, which is our stock code. The table array is the entire table of data. The column index number, well, we don't know the column index number because people can come and they can remove rows or they can add rows. So what we're going to do is use the match function because match will return the relative position in the list. So what we're looking for is in stock, the lookup array. So where are we looking for this? Well, we're looking for this across the top in our headers. And our match type is an exact match. So now we have put in our column index number and we can select an exact match and hit enter. And we can see our stock value is now pulled in as 18. So if we go down here, we can see this is now 18. Now, if we delete this column of data, the first formula with just the VLookup updated because in stock is now the second column, but this formula did not change at all. Let's look at putting in a column again. Let's put in two columns. We'll shift cells right. Let me do it again. Shift cells right. And we'll see now all of these have moved, but our in stock value is correct. So you can complete this formula and pull in the amount quantity on order and the stock value. And you can also see if we change this drop down that it is pulling in the correct in stock quantity for the particular stock code. So that's combining VLookup and match to make your VLookup formula an awful lot more dynamic.